I removed that scumbag slug, but you're sick with fever and still suffer.
Mistress of mysteries, no. I'm all right. But the mayor, Fat Fady, he stumbled upon a most sinister plot, old friend.
Ha! No, dear heart. Shroud stumbled. The mistress maneuvered. I knew of the mayor's misdeeds for many days. I followed him to that fateful meeting with Fat Fady. I was about to...
Attention! Silver Shroud and Mistress of Mystery! This is Chief Corcoran of the Boston Police Department! We know you're in there! You are blasted in connection with the murder of the mayor's office! Come out with your hands up!
It would seem that our leaving this... scene of the Scale slaughter was terribly common. Incurring the wrath of Boston's finest is an unfortunate and unexpected event.
Unexpected body.
Grieve for your worthless life!
Perhaps not by Fat Fady. I'm starting to see into his twisted plan. This shot wound.
Look, heroes! We can clear this up! Come out now, unarmed! I'll see that you two get the best lawyers in the city!
Excuse my assumption that even the most astute attorney couldn't help us now.
All right, mistress. We must away from your den and evade the police. Clear our names and take Fahey down.
That's it! We're coming in!
Silver Shroud, Mistress of Mystery, hands up for order of the Boston Police!
Chief Corcoran, I am Death's Shroud, but you are undeserved of my terrible justice. Think on my mercy.
Stop, or we'll shoot! Men, open fire! Damn it! Where did this mess come from?
Wait, it's clearing. Chief, they ain't here. They're gone!
I was hoping you'd say that, Officer Leibowitz. I was hoping you'd say that.
What will become of our stalwart hero? Find out what happens next week on another exciting episode of The Silver Shroud.
You've been listening to Galaxy News Radio, a wholly owned subsidiary of Galaxy News Network.
Galaxy News Radio.
When evil walks the streets of Boston, one man lurks in the shadows, shielding the innocent, judging the guilty. That guardian is the Silver Shroud. Today's episode, Fat Fahey's Folly.
Come on, Dollface. It's right through here.
Aw, gee, Polly. I ain't never been in a secret gangster hideout before.
What the? Polly, you dumb jamoke. What's the big idea of bringing a dame into our hideout? Into my hideout? Nah, relax, boss. She's all right. Ain't you all right, Wendy? Cindy? Yeah.
It's Candy. And yeah, of course I'm all right. I'm just a young, dumb girl in love with a handsome, dangerous man.
Ah, brother. All right, the skirt can stay, but close that door. Last thing we need is...
A silver shroud infiltrating your nefarious lair.
Holy cannoli! It's the nightmare of night, the deceptive detective, the dark dick! Paul, you idiot, you a duped! That's no normal dame!
Quite right, you custodian of criminality. For I am not Candy, the captivating companion. It is I, the mistress of mystery. I have clouded Polly's paltry perceptions to gain access to your den of depravity.
Sorry, boss! I had no idea!
Your mistake is our game! Death has come for you, evildoer! And I am its shroud!
Polly! No! Okay, listen. Whatever you want, Silver Shroud, I'll do it. Just don't kill me, too!
Pathetic and predictable when faced with fear. The cocksure culprit!
Oh, you too! Crime fighters? What a laugh! And you call me predictable? You don't got any idea, do you?
Why, the joviality fade. I, the Silver Shroud, have got you dead to rights! Yet you persist in this mindless guffawing. Not the behavior I'd expect of a criminal mastermind.
And you're right. Criminal mastermind? Me? Bub, you're as dumb as that getup. I'm just a pawn in this game, pal. You see, my master, the real master, he's been pulling all the strings.
You mean...
Days. No one cares.
That's right, mistress. This was all just a big distraction. While we were here having our little jaw session, my boss has been at your parlor, stealing back those deeds you took from Mayor Murphy's briefcase.
Treacherous toad! You defiled my sacred sanctum. For that, you will be my gun. Behold the blade of bastard!
Subsidiary of Galaxy News Network.
Galaxy News Radio.
When evil walks the streets of Boston, one man lurks in the shadows, shielding the innocent, judging the guilty. That guardian is the Silver Shroud.
Hey.
Today's episode, Into the Robot's Den.
That's all of them. Fat Fahey's mob bots have been sent back to the mechanical hell that spawned them.
Yes, my choleric companion. And no, robotic Hellspawn they were. But not Fat Fahey's. For he himself presented the facts. Someone else is actually...
the master of it all. You're right. But who? Dearest Mistress of Mysteries, you and I have battled Boston's Rogues Gallery for years. This is someone new.
Certainly. But which criminal culprit has the technological know-how to construct such clockwork calamities? I don't...
You don't know anything? Yeah, right. But I do see. And I'll tell you too. On one condition. By the shadowed streets of Southie, one of the mob bot's heads.
What the fuck was that?
He's still talking. You darn right I am. I can't feel my legs, cause you shot me up good, Shroud. But I still got my kisser, see? And I'm gonna use it to tell you where the big boss man is, see? And your one condition. You take my head with you, so's I can see you take that creep down. Yeah, what did he ever do for me, huh? Okay, so he created me. Whoop-dee-doo. Who needs a father who sends his kids out to die?
Silver Shroud, I sense truth in this clockwork crook. Shall I?
Use your blade of bastard to free the Mabot's head from its now destroyed body. Do it. Ha! Sweet freedom! Thanks, Dollface! Now tell us, who is your creator? The robotic puppet master pulling your twisted wires? Speak, you decapitated electronic evildoer!
What the hell was that?
That will spoil all the fun! You gotta see for yourself! Come on, let's beat feet to the big warehouse down at Pier 12!
What's that?
Fine, you amoral automaton. We're away!
Stupid noises!
A moonless night and an unguarded skylight. Just what we needed to stealthily infiltrate this warehouse.
Yes, and our view from above is advantageous, for the gathering below is unlike any soiree I've ever seen.
Robots! Dozens of them, all shapes and sizes, and on the stage, their leader, another robot. No, not a robot! A man in a robot costume! Us robots got good hearing! Gotta get yourselves caught. Now listen, boss man's about that talk. My robotic children, my glorious creations, we stand tonight at the dawn of a new era. For too long, human vermin of monsters have destroyed this fair city. The flesh is weak, but steel is strong. You, my children, will usher in a new age, an age of robots. Led by me, your father, the Mechanist! The Mechanist? So, evil does have a name. The revolution begins tonight, my precious offspring. But first, let us welcome our special guests for this evening. Silver Shroud and the Mistress of Mysteries.
Wayne got what was coming to him.
And so shall
we. Find out what happens next week on another exciting episode of The Silver Shroud.
Session. My boss has been at your parlor, stealing back notes.
Toad. You defiled my sacred sanctum.
Do it again.
For that, you will be my fury. Behold the blade of Basta.
Something like you dust up to get the oil. Hey.
Mistress, no. We needed him alive.
That was never going to happen. I ain't never been alive, you see.
By the shadows, Fat Fahey, he's a robot.
Wow. Ain't you quite the detective? Too bad your career as a crime fighter is over. Robots attack!
Monster robots assaulting from all angles. Not even the Silver Shroud can kill what isn't alive.
Watch me, mistress. Watch me.
Good picking. What will become of our stalwart hero? Find out what happens next week on another exciting episode of The Silver Shroud.
You've been listening to Galaxy News Radio, a wholly owned subsidiary of Galaxy News Network.
Galaxy News Radio.
When evil walks the streets of Boston, one man lurks in the shadows, shielding the innocent, judging the guilty. That guardian is the Silver Shroud. Today's episode, Into the Robot's Den.
That's all of them. Fat Fahey's mob bots have been sent back to the mechanical hell that spawned them.
Yes, my choleric companion. And no, robotic hellspawn they were. But not Fat Fahey's. For
yes.
He himself presented the facts. Someone else is actually...
the master of it all. You're right. But who? Dearest mistress of mysteries, you and I have battled Boston's rogues gallery for years. This is someone.
Certainly. But which criminal culprit has the technological know-how to construct such clockwork calamities? I don't...
You don't know anything. Yeah, right. But I do see. And I'll tell you too. On one condition. By the shadowed streets of Southie, one of the mob bots' heads is still talking. You're darn right I am. I can't feel my legs, cause you shot me up good, Shroud. But I still got my kisser, see? And I'm gonna use it to tell you where the big boss man is, see? And your one condition? You take my head with you, so I can see you take that creep down. Yeah, what did he ever do for me, huh? Okay, so he created me.
You must be Kendra.
And you're the crazy one in the costume.
Silver Shroud, I sense truth in this clockwork crook. Shall I?
I do so
use your blade of bastard to free the Mabot's head from its now destroyed body. Do it.
Who's your boss?
A walking corpse like you shouldn't trouble yourself about that.
Now tell us. Pulling your twisted wires. Speak, you decapitated electronic evildoer.
That will spoil all the fun. You gotta see for yourself. Come on, let's beat feet to the big warehouse down at Pier 12.
Fine, you amoral automaton. We're away.
A moonless night in an unguarded skylight. Just what we needed to stealthily infiltrate this warehouse.
Yes, and our view is advantageous, for the gathering below is unlike any soiree I've ever seen.
Robots, dozens of them, all shapes and sizes, and on the stage, their leader, another robot, no, not a robot, a man in a robot costume.
Shh, shut up, you dummies. Us robots got good hearing. You're gonna get yourselves caught. Now listen, boss man's about to talk.
My robotic children, my glorious creations, we stand tonight at the dawn of a new era. For too long, the human vermin of Boston have destroyed this fair city. The flesh is weak, but steel, steel is strong. You, my children, will usher in a new age, an age of robots, led by me, your father, the Mechanist!
The Mechanist? So, evil does have a name.
The revolution begins tonight, my precious offspring. But first, let us welcome our special guests for this evening. Silver Shroud and the Mistress of Mystery.
Stalwart hero! Find out what happens next week on another exciting episode of The Silver Shroud!
You've been listening to Galaxy News Radio, a wholly owned subsidiary of Galaxy News Network.
Galaxy News Radio!
When evil walks the streets of Boston, one man lurks in the shadows, shielding the innocent, judging the guilty. That guardian is the Silver Shroud. Today's episode, The Mechanist Unleashed.
Dangling over a pit of fire reminds me of our adventure against the Chelsea Mingler, a mistress.
Indeed, Stalwart Shroud. But that malformed murderer was but a muppet compared to the malignancy of the Mechanist.
Malignant, am I? No, Mistress of Mystery. What you mistake for evil is actually enlightenment. Only I, the Mechanist, truly understand the folly of humankind. The flesh is weak. Metal is the future of Massachusetts.
Certainly doesn't need that anymore.
Some very bad people may be coming. It's not safe here.
I don't know you. Just go away. I don't know you. Just go away.
Hello?
Hello?
What's up?
Eating my dinner.
That's nice. Sir, did you get anything from the chest?
No.
That's pretty good.
Radio.
Did I get anything from the chest?
Hey,
yeah.
Literally, moldering shards, worm spore,
and
another light.
I think I got the same stuff, but I'm not sure.
Yeah.
We didn't get much farther from there.
Do you have any idea what you're doing this weekend?
I'm going to my dad's. I'm going to my grandma's, I mean.
And, are you going to your grandma's?
Yeah, but tomorrow, I guess, from what I was told, is me and Dave are going to work at Gramps until we, until y'all eat and stuff.
Yeah, well, I'm going to be leaving.
Hey.
I'm gonna be leaving for work at 5:30, and then I'll be working until 10:30.
Kind of crazy.
Well, I got Easter weekend off, so we're gonna go to West Virginia.
Yeah, David told me about that.
Yeah, I'll be back.
Case. But these are real estate papers. These
from most of the businesses in Scarlet Square.
Indeed they are, my intrepid investigator. It would seem our Mayor Murphy was involved in a rather crooked caper. He was here to meet with some other mysterious malefactor.
So, Mr. Mayor, I hope you found the place all good. What the? Silver Shroud? And Mistress of Mystery? And the Mayor? Dead?
That fatty, the infamous Mammoth. So, you were meeting with Mayor Murphy. But why? Tell me, and you may yet live.
Best listen to my friend, Fahey.
I'll never talk. You two are in over your heads.
So be it. Death has come for you, evildoer. And I am it.
Shroud. Shroud this crime fighter. Later, suckers.
Silver Shroud, you're shot.
Just a graze. You must go after him.
No, we'll let our quarry flee for now. That bullet must be removed. And you're bleeding badly.
Must get
better keep your iron
back to my...
Hush now, Stoic Shroud. I'll take you to my parlor. It is close, and that wound is worrisome.
What, pals now? Gonna shoot the breeze? Take a walk.
The parlor. It's been so long.
Indeed it has.
If you're sticking around, you'll need to join a crew. I hear Bobby No-Nose is looking. Always a catch with the No-Nose, but she pays.
Too bad about Finn. Gonna miss him next Super Mutant Attack rolls round. Oh well. What can I do for our newcomer?
Looking for work.
Work, huh? I'll tell you what, I got reconnaissance needs. There's a lot of weird talk coming in about a place called the Pikmin Gallery. It's Raider territory up there, but they've been quiet. Like uncomfortable post-coitus quiet. Snoop it out and give me the word.
Scout out Pikmin Gallery. On it.
Cool. Be thorough, okay? I'm not paying for a look-see. Find out what's really going on there.
Mayor Hancock?
Hey, I don't mean to bitch, but aren't you supposed to be heading to Pikmin Gallery for me? Something else?
Did I hear you talking about the Institute?
You like my little speech? I do it every once in a while in case they're listening in. I want those synth makers to know that Good Neighbor is off limits. No one gets replaced in my town. But hey, weren't we talking about your needs? What did you come here for?
Why does the Institute replace people?
Hell if I know. Mess with people's heads, control us from the shadows, or maybe they do it. No one knows where the Institute is, what kind of people they are, or why they've decided to engineer their own slaves.
Uh-huh.
Just to be clear, everyone's welcome in Good Neighbor. I don't care if you're a synth, ghoul, and let me tell you, synths still under the Institute's control don't play nice. Done talking about this. What else you need?
What's your story, Hancock?
My favorite subject. I came into this town about a decade ago. Had a smooth set of skin back then. While I was busy making myself a pillar of this community, I would go on these, like, wild tears. Any chems I could find, the more exotic, the better. Finally found this experimental radiation drug. Only one of its kind left, and only one hit. Oh man, the high was so worth it. Yeah, I'm living with the side effects, but hey, what's not to love about immortality?
You're immortal?
Well, not exactly. Ghouls just age really, really slow. Something about the rads, maybe? Who knows?
You're a hell of a risk taker, Hancock.
Only have one life. Why not try it all? Anyway, Did you need something else?
Tell me more about this town of yours, good neighbor.
It's all about the people, understand? They're freaks, misfits, and troublemakers. And that's why everyone here lives their own life, their own way. Now, was there anything else?
Looking for more work, if you got...
Nothing right now, sorry. But check around the neighborhood.
A new player in good neighborhood. Hello, little pawn. Welcome to our fun and games.
Guess what someone tells me. Some costume freak is operating in Good Neighbor. And the kicker is, it ain't me. How should I feel about this?
This neighborhood is ill. I am the cure.
You're priceless. Like the Silver Shroud himself walked out of a comic book into my den. Just priceless. You've been busy scaring people, bashing in a few faces. I respect that. So far. But I gotta ask, one freak to another, why the getup?
Many have sought to pierce the shroud to no avail.
You just don't stop. Stay you, pal. The lowlifes you took out all belong to the same asshole. And that asshole's planning some old-fashioned revenge on you. You dig? Fortunate for you. I want Sinjin to take a dirt nap. He's taken 2-bit raider outfits and made them scary. Small fish now, but if left alone...
He will be judged for his crimes.
Trust me, he needs a lot of judging.
I have returned.
Got a lead on two of his own. Smiling Kate and Northy. Smiley is gathering a posse to take you out. And Northy is just running scared. Hired himself
I
some goons.
I did my sleep.
Prospect.
Huh?
Just keep
I died in my sleep.
Body bags up until you find the location of the big guy himself.
Sinjin thinks he's above judgment, but no one is safe.
Don't you like got a shower
shroud.
To get or something?
Don't get killed. You deal with Sinjin.
After I'm done eating and drinking my milk, I'll have a dirt ball. I mean, I come home smelling like Arby's. The sweet, sweet smell that all women love. Bow chicka bow wow.
Arby's, we have the meat.
Gaggedy. Bum 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 bum. Just gotta wait for Tuesday and things are gonna get a lot better around here.
DLC comes out that day?
Yup.
Fun times.
Oh yeah. And they're bringing back a character I enjoy quite a lot. I'm gonna steal his clothes. Bow chicka bow wow. But yeah, I'm gonna have so much fun building robots. It's gonna be Pokemon 3.0.
God damn it.
What?
I'm just imagining it now. You're gonna be like, Robo 1, I choose you.
No, I'm gonna have names for them. Joe, I use you!
How's work?
Busy, but you know. Yeah, some guy was playing him at work, and I'm just like, man, I don't know anyone that knows this band.
Is that Camden?
No, I don't know who the lead singer is.
It is Camden. Oh my.
Yes, Cole, it's Camden.
Hello!
Isn't the boy behind the costume? You've been really
nice. You're not losing your mind yet.
Making all my friends so nervous with your calling cards. Taking out Sinjin's favorite toy soldiers.
How's my buddy doing?
Now it's time to
went to the bathroom, so.
Yeah. That's hot. This girl said she's gonna rip my heart out. That's hot and kinky. I'm into that stuff. We're playing catch right now, if you know what I mean. I'm lobbing grenades at her. Yeah, I'm always the pitcher. Oh, I got a new scout rifle on Destiny.
Oh.
Yeah, it has like a suppressor on it or something. It looks amazing.
That's cool.
Yep, I just executed her.
That's always fun.
Yeah, we had a good time. I killed all of her bodyguards in like a matter of like 4 seconds. Grenades really get the point across.
Finding good help is so hard to find these days.
Not really, just throw me at them.
Hey.
But I mean, the only way to truly find out if someone's worth being a guard or not is if they can survive a jumping puzzle.
Jeez.
I swear to God, that's like my favorite part of the raid to this day.
That doesn't surprise me.
It was so fun, especially watching you guys fail.
Josh and Bill are not any.
No, Steven.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, Steven more than Josh, because Josh didn't know what he was doing. But Steven, he was way back there. Are you sure you wouldn't want to play this, Jamie? The Mechanist expansion?
I said I would if I had time.
No, I'm saying on my console if I brought it over.
Probably. And since we're going West Virginia this weekend, I'll probably come and try it for most of the time.
Next weekend.
And I get paid that Friday too, so hey.
This dog's trying to shake my hand. I mean, so you could just easily throw 10 out of that paycheck for it.
Yeah.
Right. You still got all those concerts and stuff. Although, me personally, I would have threw down for the thing with Jig. Killed your dog, and I'm running away now because I'm an asshole. Hit and run, motherfucker. And there's raiders here. Don't mind me, just running through here, pals. Yeah, it's raiders versus super mutants right now. And I think there's some mercenaries here too, but I'm not sure. All I know is there's a crap ton of people, and I do not feel like fighting. Because I would have to loot every single one of them. Wait, do I hear the Brotherhood of Steel? I do. You know what the biggest clusterfuck on this game has been so far? Bunker Hill. I managed to get managed to set it up to where I got every single faction in the fight there, and it was amazing.
What?
Oh.
Yeah.
Grenade.
I'm excited for that album.
Jamie,
you're out of grenades. I got five health for you. I'm down there as soon as I wake up and just hit to it. I swear I'll get
of course. Press download.
No.
I actually heard a few of them, so.
Yes.
iTunes account, so. Second it hits 12 o'clock.
Now, Camden, you should be in bed by then, buddy.
New album.
It's
really good.
I am like, I listen as soon as I heard "Hate by Design." I'm just like, yeah, this album's gonna be good.
Yeah.
Who else? A Day Remembers' new song is
but I have three things to say. It sounds like three songs that I know of.
You know they lost that, right?
No. They're on the Data Remember records.
No, they're not. I'll argue with you on this. Read some articles, man. They lost that fight. That huge, like, custody fight, how they were supposed to do five albums and everything. They lost it. This up-and-coming album is their last album. It is part of a Data Remember records. Is co-signed on it because it's them.
Yeah.
Is this Data Remember the band that we're talking about?
Yes, it's the band we're talking about, Paul.
Okay. Because I heard their records and I didn't hear what band.
Anyways, their new song is pretty good, and it reminds me of BYOB by System of a Down, Ace of Spades from Motorhead, and I just now realized it kind of reminds me of Bush from Nine Inch Nails.
Hey, Jamie. System of Down Syndrome.
Yeah.
Down syndrome, Jamie.
I'm trying to think who else released music. I See Stars' new song is. It's okay. I like it too, it's just. It's very different as far as the screaming approach because it seems like very weak compared to the old screamer.
Yeah, well, Jamie, I don't hear you screaming.
Oh well, I've been listening to Carnifex and Whitechapel religiously at this point.
School shooter. Why?
No.
He's a cat that you are. Music buff you are. You don't know that.
I've just been recently.
We're all disappointed in you, Jamie.
It's about them loving Texas.
They want to cause.
Alright. I'll still like Whitechapel though.
I lead out that.
I mean, I like Whitechapel. I'm not dissing them, but.
They're not the kind of band you. Deathcore band you'd go looking for.
Literally can scream louder than a fucking PA system.
See, I think recently, after Mitch passed from Suicide Silence, they personally like dropped off my radar in all seriousness.
That's disrespectful.
No.
Yeah, you all. Every single person you just said that used to like All Shall Perish.
Yeah.
Yeah, I wonder why you like these Suicide Silence.
Quite honestly, I've been listening to Job for a Cowboy again recently. No, that's the side part. They did. A lot of good deathcore bands have not been putting out anything as good as they used to. No. Oh, really?
I like that band.
Jamie, I like that band.
I'd be down for that. Besides, like, did I tell you about me and my friend's business we've got starting up? Well, it's officially has a name, and we have all of our services and stuff figured out. Alright, guys. We do, like, DJing for, like, weddings and stuff, as well as recording music and things like that.
That's funny.
Like, dude, not even
I
like.
Literally know 6 days out of the longest, and we're going to teach you anything you want to know, and you're super fucked up, dude, man.
It's not even like DJing, like scratching discs or anything. It's more of like.
Dude, no, nobody scratches vinyl anymore.
I know.
If you can scratch vinyl, you're a badass. I'll straight up tell you it.
Yeah.
Because no one, it's all electronic. It's all electronic now. It's all pre-done setting.
Powering up a song. Protectron on duty.
I feel with it.
But.
The only thing I can do is I don't care for that.
But yeah, the first thing. Our first, like, actual business thing we're doing is we're doing the music and stuff for one of my close friends' wedding in June.
That's awesome.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's it.
So did I hear that DJ Asylum's in the house?
Shithead out there, call me. Everything you do is worth something. Don't get yourself short.
Yeah.
Don't underbid yourself. Hey, sorry, you know, I didn't see that. What's going on? Oh, well, I'm kind of booked now. I mean, I can come and rush to you, but charge more. But don't burn bridges, make friends.
Yeah. Alright, I'm gonna shower and probably go to bed.
Good choices. I would do that.
All right, I'll see you later. Later.
Bye, DJ Asylum.
Nice, right, I'll talk to you later.
Yeah.
the hell was that?
Thank you.
little bleeder!
What's all this, then?
Every weapon you see here could be the difference between life.
Let's see what you got.
Let's get you outfitted.
Uh-huh.
You call that a gun?
Oh, it's you. Oh, Sugar. I told Kent all that hero stuff was going to get you both killed. Oh, God. Oh, God.
Easy. I'm here now. Tell me what happened.
It was terrible. A dozen raiders. They just charged in and grabbed Kent. Took him away. When they took him away, they left you a message. Just listen to Kent's radio station. It keeps playing it over and over again.
This is the Shroud's headquarters. So you must be the Silver Shroud's little friend.
Yes.
If you want to see your friend alive, Shroud, meet me at Milton General Hospital.
Handle your own problems.
Don't do it, Shroud. It's a trap. Save yourself.
You're looking to stock up on general equipment. You can get Daisy's distance.
Oh, my God. Do it, Shroud. Do it. On my knee.
Nice pit boy.
Tick-tock, Shroud. Kill to get that. Don't keep me waiting. We got business that needs finishing.
Here's a Silver Shroud update. In case you missed it, Kendra's reign of terror is over. She won't be... What? Oh, God, what's happening?
On your knees, dirtbag.
No, wait. Medical miracles do exist. Mr. James, taking a trip down memory lane with that?
Someone there?
Going down. Going up. Second floor.
out there. Oh, hell no!
Mr. Jenkins, Puppet's able to carry more than you, eh?
Come on, tough guy, come on!
The jet will make you get... Okay, cut the shit. Who is that? You sure you saw something?
Shroud! I want to talk with you! I'm gonna say it again. Hold, assholes! Anyone turns heel, I'm coming for you and your family. And you, Shroud, you step any closer, and we get to see what's inside Kent's head.
If you have something to say, I'm listening.
Some of these losers are still waiting for the legendary Silver Shroud. They think the Shroud walked straight out of a comic book. But you and I know, the Shroud's just you in a stupid, flea-ridden costume. You're weak. You came here. And for what? Your little sidekick?
Friends don't make you weak. They make you strong.
I can play you like a chump because you care about a weakling like this. And you think that's strength? So what's gonna happen is this. I'm going to kill Kent. Then we're gonna shoot the hell out of you. Nothing's gonna be left but paste. Then, I'm going to Good Neighbor to kill every last worthless bastard there and burn the whole thing down. No one screws with Sinjin.
You know what would really get to Kent? Killing his friend, his hero, right in front of him.
Enjoy the show, Kent. After I'm done with the Shroud, you're next. Say goodnight.
Kent.
I've never been so happy to see anyone in my entire life.
I'm glad I got here in time.
You and me both, Shroud. But I don't know. I just give up. On all of it. Crime fighting just isn't what I thought it'd be.
What? That's your call to make.
I'm going back to Good Neighbor. Really, thanks for saving me, but I'm just done.
If you have something...
Some of these loot, but you and I know. You came here.
Friends don't make...
I can play you like... So what's gonna happen is... Then we're gonna shoot the hell out of you. Then? No one.
What happens is this. Everyone that points a gun at me... dies. Every last one.
Jesus. Since you can't do anything to us if he's dead.
Cowards! coward!
Don't do anything rash, Sid.
Rash?
Mm-hmm.
Some of these losers are still waiting for the legend. But you and I know. You came here.
Friends don't make you weak. They make...
I can play you like... So what's gonna happen? Then we're gonna shoot the hell out of you. Then? I'm going... No one.
You know what would really get to Kent?
Say goodnight.
I've never been so happy to see anyone in my entire life.
I'm glad I got here in time.
You and me both, Shroud. I just give up.
If you just quit, then the bad guys have already won.
You're right. I'm going back to Good Neighbor.
Right.
Just need time to recover, you know?
Got it. Hey.
Can I, sir, perhaps now is a good time?
Sure, Codsworth. What's up?
Oh, just a little something I'd like to get off the old proverbial chest. I just want to say what an honor it is for me to accompany you. You've no idea the horror these past two centuries have wrought. The initial destruction. Not knowing if you and your family were all right. It was a relief just to find the entrance intact.
I'm sorry, Codsworth. It was so sudden.
Not even time for goodbyes.
Not a single worry, sir, as I shared your priorities completely. Family safety first, above all else. And yes, while it was hard at first, I was able to eventually move on. At first, it was the work, busying myself day and night, and believe me, there was plenty of it. But eventually, the work became light chores. What truly saved me was my memories, sir. Memories of you and the missus, young Shaw, of your love and kindness. I soldiered on, fueled by hope that one day, if not you and the wife, that Shaun, or perhaps Shaun's children, would one day emerge.
I'm glad you stuck around.
Oh, sir, you don't know how good it is to hear you say that. I just wanted you to know how much I consider you family. I may be a mere robot to some, but I do hope you've come to see me as more.
I consider you to be family too, Codsworth. We're in this world for the long haul. Together.
Mr. James? You don't know how wonderful it is for me to hear that. I feel completely recharged. Well, enough blither-blather from me. Let's get back to it, shall we?
Hey.
Mr. James.
Keep your iron strength.
Cleo.
I hope you're buying. Even a girl with...
Let's see what you have.
Purchase a variety in case of boredom.
I could use one of those robots.
As could every household.
Daisy.
Means a lot to me that you made the library a safer place. Thank you.
Let's see what you have.
It's a little bit of everything.
something you need.
No? Ain't surprising. The Institute wiped the place off the map.
Nice, Pip-Boy. You kill to get that, huh?
Go ahead. I just need time to recover, you know?
You ever tried chess? Sometimes you need to sacrifice a piece to keep the game going. Keep that in mind.
The deed is done. The dreaded St. John breathes no more.
All by your lonesome, you took down the big bad St. John. We get to walk that tightrope of freedom one more day. Take this for the effort.
You played your part in serving justice to those most deserving of it.
I'm gonna miss these little conversations. Ah, Kent, my man. Why the long face? You got what you wanted.
I was tortured. Almost died. It's not like the radio plays at all.
Hey, who hasn't been tortured from time to time? The price of throwing down with the man is always a few scars. Pick yourself up. Good neighbor's just a bit safer thanks to the two of you.
What would the Shroud be without his faithful friend, Red Reinhardt?
This means a lot to me. I'm gonna need some time to heal, you know? But then I got a special project in mind, just for you. I'll fire up my radio station if I make any progress.
We didn't get to the top of this town.